main objectives of this project, but one of the main objectives is to stop these deaths.
The width of our road is 3 meters. On the right side, it is covered by an open drainage system. On top of this drainage system is 2 meters. On both sides of the road, it's covered by plants which were initially meant for walking but are now covered with stalls of vegetables and other things.
Also,
the width of this road is 2 meters and it's covered on the right side by an open drainage system and its width is 2 meters. On both sides of the road, there are plants which are initially meant for walking but are not covered with stalls of vegetables and other things.
There is no management or garden present in that area. What was really shocking that the government officer himself froze garbage on road or drainage system. This has led to the clogging of drains.
Water. The water supply in that area is very good. Even though residents have not installed purification systems, water is very pure. There is a municipal pumping station through which water is pumped 14 hours a day. Also, there is a chlorination plant through which water is purified.
Drainage in this area is just a little better than average but not good. They use an open drainage system to pure water, but so the drainage system.
Now basically the problems which we found in this road, there were main 3 problems in this road. The first problem was that there was no footpath. As you can see, the government had made some footpaths, but the markets that were placed on the footpaths used that area to keep their things, and that is very annoying for the residents that live there. Many residents also complained that when they are walking on the road is so narrow that sometimes they get hit by a rickshaw or the bicycle, as you can see in our survey forms. And the second problem is that there are very narrow roads, as I stated. As you can see, here the cars park here. So where will the residents walk? The road is very narrow. It is not even wide enough for 2 cars. The third problem which the residents face is that there are huge garbage piles. The total area that are occupied by the garbage is so much that an apartment can easily be constructed on it. And the smell of this garbage also annoys the residents. The fourth problem is that there are clogging of open drains. As there is open drainage system, many residents throw their garbage on drains and therefore it gets clogged. There are many disturbances on this road, namely stray dogs and cows. There is a cow shed nearby and therefore the cows there disturb a lot of residents. What are the solutions to these problems?
Here are the solutions. Covering up the drainage system. This scheme is currently being used in Ashiana Road and it is working successfully. It has 2 benefits. I would eradicate 2 problems. With the drainage covered, there would be no smell and therefore no complaints from the residents. The other would be that it would widen the road and therefore there would be space for the footpath. Converting the garbage disposal area into a park. During a site inspection, we saw huge areas that had been covered with garbage of piles and also immediate foul smell. We wanted to clear this area and make it into a park as it was a breeding ground for disease causing germs. This would also eradicate the problem of no parks and huge piles of garbage. Placing solar street ground lines. To separate the road from the footpath, we could use solar ground lines. This scheme is being used in Bowling Road and it is working successfully. This would also save the energy used by street lights.
Now let us discuss the present situation of the PMT locality. The blue boxes that you see represent the shop which cover a lot of area of the road, which makes it difficult for the residents to live. The black paint shows the drain, which is uncovered and open. The orange boxes are the well-built houses in which residents live, and the yellow boxes are huts. The green ones represent the trees, and the green paint is for the feet in the field.
Now, what changes have been made in the future map? As you can see, the nodes here are crab and there is a drainage system. But in our future map, the road is smooth and the drainage system has been covered by the road. This widens the road and it is very easier for the residents to move, and it makes this road one of the best in our city. Also, to replace all these stalls, we have made updates, shopping complex, where they could place their stalls and sell this. This would use relatively less area and therefore they would not cover the road. We have done the same thing here, and here where there are weeds and open areas and there are no use. So we have made a playground. So, because there is no park in this area and the children they are very annoyed by this. After this, we have also made a park and recreational center here. In our future present map, this was an area full of weeds. But we have made this a park and recreational center, and also we have replaced all the huts by a rehabilitation center, so that the people that are living there can live here, but it is much more easier to the eyes. The same things we have done in the model. We have placed street lights and we have also made a circuit day globe. Lend your hand to save the land.
Today's show is special as we have some of our limited resources friends from a place called Mushatoli, situated in Bihar. People is development. There is a section in this society which always there. Now, friends, can you please tell what does Musha mean?
Actually, I'm not sure, but I'm sure Tejas knows it.
Yeah, Mushatoli are the people who kill the rats and eat them. Do you know that they are also called rat trappers?
So please welcome Mrs. Phool Kanta Devi
and comfortable, and please try to answer our questions honestly.
So be frank and tell us about all your problems.
Yes, Phool Kanta ji, please begin. In everyday life, we face a lot of problems, but we are not asking for modern facilities. We are just asking for our basic needs, which are essential for our survival.
Yes, Babu Ramji, is there a sarpanch in your area?
No. I have a ward council, but a so-called.
I think we should do something for their betterment.
Yes, why not?
Thanks for giving your precious time with us.
Thank you, friends. Oh my God, sis! Do they really live like this?
Yes, dear. That's the show all about.
That's the show. We have to do something. We have to do something.
In your time, we have the opportunity to move not only towards the rich society as a powerful society, but also upwards the great society. With these kinds of latent needs, Johnson, we commence the presentation for us to exist. It was all about awareness and the formation of victim that. Now let's move on.
Yes, who are you and what do you want?
We are a group from DPS Patna and we want to know about a problem.
Problem? Interview? What kind of interview?
No, I don't need any interview.
Ma'am, we just want a small interview. Ma'am, and it will help to develop your area.
I just go give it.
Ma'am, a small interview. We want to know about your problem.
Problems? You want to know about our problems? We have no electricity, no street lights,
even no drainage system. Ma'am, try to understand, ma'am.
Get out! Now!
I'm talking to a school girl.
Please wait. We want your help.
I would be more than happy to do so.
So what are the problems you face? I mean, when you live in this area?
Yes.
This area itself is a big problem. As you can see, rains clog and garbage lying everywhere. There is no drainage system.
Why don't you complain? You have a ward counselor.
We do complain. However, our complaint just falls on deaf ears.
Please, can you elaborate?
When we complain to the ward parishioner, her answer is always the same, that she looked into the matter, but she never does.
Okay, thank you for your help.
This was the very first glimpse of this was a small glimpse of our very first interview. We gathered information and went to the ward parishioner.
Is this the home of ward counselor?
Yes, what do you want to know?
We are a group from DPS Patna.
please come inside.
Yes, yes.
Yes, children, what do you want to know?
We want to know about the development you have done. Musha Doli.
Development? Oh, Musha Doli. Is that my area?
Yes.
Has Rukanpura come to your area?
Yes, Rukanpura is my area.
Ward number 3 and comes in your area?
Ward number 3? Yeah, I suppose it's my area.
Well, then Musha Doli is there.
Musha Doli. Well, then what do you want to know?
Development you have done.
Look, I have put 2 street lights.
One is not working.
Well, I'll do hand pumps also.
Only one work.
Is that sufficient for them?
I suppose yes.
There are 600 people. How can they manage in one hand pump?
Well, look, I've got some work to do. So, can you please come later? Please try to work on Musha Doli also.
It is
I'll try that.
So, my work comes to the
Good morning. So, how can I help you?
So, we are a group from PKS Patna and we have come here to show up our project on Musha Doli, the road in Ward number 3.
So, where is Musha Doli?
This is Rukanpura.
Do you know the ward number?
It's Ward number 3, sir.
Okay, so can you please explain me your project so that I can provide you help?
Sure, please see.
Yes.
We have made 2 maps for the project.
Okay.
So this is the original map which was already there.
The roads
are not straight here. And there are 2 street lights out of which only one works.
And the proposed map, we have increased the street light. And from 2, we have increased it to 6.
You can also see the model which we have proposed.
Nice effort.
We have put a business sector in which the people of the Musha Doli would be given work. Also, the abandoned area in the back, which was used for garbage, is now turned into an agricultural field.
Is there any school?
Yes, of course. There was one school before which was not working, but we have talked to the government and put up a new one.
Okay, so I can help you. Superintendent Engineer, please accompany them to the site and provide help to them.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
As you can see, sir, this is the condition of Musha Doli.
Excuse me, what do you do?
I collect garbage.
I also.
Actually, sir, they all collect garbage, so we have a very good proposal for them. Come, people.
Yes, yes.
Please show them and explain it.
Look, you all collect garbage. So what we are asking you to do is, you collect the garbage of your own area and divide it into 2 parts, the biodegradable and the non-biodegradable. Okay? The biodegradable, all the vegetable leaves, etc. Right?
Yes, yes.
And the non-biodegradable, the stainless steel, whatever you get. Then you put the biodegradable in a composting bin. You get managed for that and you have to sell it to the farmers or the NGOs. And what you have to do with the non-biodegradable, sell it to the recycling unit, not the kabadiwalas. Look, you will have benefits and only benefits. First, you will get a cleaner and a healthier road to live in. Second, you will get money, that is economic upliftment. And the third and the most common problem, sanitation would be solved.
Arey bhai, ye suvidha bahut achhi hai.
Sahi mein.
We are leaving the morning bell, moving down to the smoothie bed. We are moving away from pollution. We are giving away to motivation. Clean ways, we need it. Garbage and judge away. Yes, we need it. Yeah, we need it.
one with a stoppage at the station or roundabout. We interviewed the drivers and the conductors of these buses and also distributed survey forms among the students of these buses and received a meager response.
From our observations and sorting of data, there seem to be only three major problems of the road. Garbage piles are side of the road and no proper dustbins are there. And the PNC, that is the Patna Municipal Corporation, has fixed a garbage collecting system. But according to the source, it's irregular. When inquiring PNC, we found that the garbage is collected before 10 AM. But people throw garbage even after that. They pile the garbage in poly bags and leave them on the sidewalks and the dividers. Lack of dustbins don't help this problem.
On the whole length of the road, there are only 3 to 4 street lights that also not in working condition. The PESO has cut off the electricity supply due to an internal conflict between PESO and PNC. The matters are still pending with the government to be resolved.
Now we come to the biggest problem, traffic. Such a rush of traffic is mainly caused due to the unsystematic flow of traffic. Here, on this part of the Kolhapur is an intersection gated by a divider. The people who wish to enter the station premises can enter the station by using the left hand divider and enter the station. Now on the right side, people can pass straight to the other side of the road. The people exiting from the station starts mingling with the traffic flow from around here. If in case the exit of the station is blocked, a whole line of traffic starts forming and eventually the Kolhapur is obstructed. The hawkers and the vendors who encroach almost 1/3 of the road adds to this chaos.
All of the tenders are stuck with them and
advertised here, and the streetlight situation is being resolved.
Then, on our list was Mr. Avinash, the director of PNC, and specifically affronted about the encroachments. We got to know that plans were being made to shift encroachments around the station road to the vending zones. Astonishingly, this plan coincided with our suggestions.
We went over to the cabin of Mr. Shashank, the Chief Executive Officer of PNC. He was approving the pedestrian subway and considering it more.
Mr. Anil Kumar, the Assistant Engineer of Road Construction Department, listened to our proposal and gave a suggestion. He was fully confident of our one-way exit plan.
Then we went up to Mr. S. Devakar, Officer on Special Duty to the Commissioner, to bring under his notice the problem of garbage disposal. He alleged that he would look into the monitoring of garbage collection and that the dustbins had been sanctioned and could be in place in just a few months. Now, when you go to the station road, you will find that he has returned to his board and the garbage of the area has been cleared.
Since a bridge is being constructed on the road we have chosen, we go up to the Bihar State Rajya Pul Nirman Nigam and ask Mr. Suresh Kumar about the structure. The space between the pillars of the bridge will be used as parking area to reduce illegal parking.
For the retrofitting of the old and dangerous buildings of Newmarket, we consulted Mr. Chanchal Kumar, the Secretary of Bhavan Nirman Vibhag. He approved our plan and even said that with sufficient R&R, this can be got in question.
Our last meeting was with Mr. Pratyay Amrit, the Road Secretary. He told us that obviously the one-way exit plan has to be brought into action once the Kalabur journey to Mithapur, Kalabur and GRF Kalabur reaches the Kalabur, which is near the station road. And we also know that the plan of the pedestrian subway is another big thing and will be soon a reality by 2015.
Our second step was the sensitization of the public. You would ask, why is that needed? Isn't the government fully responsible for this? I say, this is fully no. We, as the best citizens, are also responsible for the same. To make this more understandable, we are going to present this case based on a real-life incident which happened with us on the station road.
Excuse me, can you not throw the bottle in the dustbin?
Who are you to dictate me?
I am a citizen of this city. I pay taxes from the taxes of road tax.
Instill this idea in every citizen, we have come up with awareness campaign. We went to the station road and put up banners, and each of us put up posters and chanted slogans on road safety, pedestrian etiquette, garbage disposal, etc.
Crowd was attracted, they are strong, we made them aware about how small changes in their behavior could bring about big improvements.
We also distributed pamphlets on the above-mentioned topics for passers-by at the station road. In a not totally unrelated approach, we pasted posters at the back of the buses of our schools that pass the station road or have stops.
Then to garner a wider audience for our initiative, we used one of the most popular mediums of communication, the radio. We went on air about 10 minutes on Radio Mirchi 98.3 FM, its call, and talked to RJ Anjali about our project.
We have also sent letters to editors of leading newspapers to help us in our needs, and we have also filed an anti-mail campaign to Mr. Kudeep Narayan, Commissioner of Patna Municipal Corporation.
We went to the shopkeepers in the new market and got their written word that they won't throw garbage on the streets. We even created a Facebook page to get together as many people as we can.
सामना पहुंचने के लिए हमें करना पड़ता है परेशानियों का सामना।
तो फिर हम पहुंचने की करते ही क्यों है कामना?
तो
encroachments are high, the roads not so wide, lots of garbage and waste lying aside. That's not all, when it's after midnight, you won't find a single source of light. Na 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 na. When station road ke paas, jab bhi aap jaoge, कचरा कचरे और गंदगी के अलावा और कुछ नहीं पाओगे,
तो एक अच्छे नागरिक की तरह रखे स्टेशन रोड का सहारा।
कूड़ा कचरा अगर फैलाया तो गलती भी होगी माफ। ना 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 ना
future generation.
Actually,
disasters. These are traffic, street lightning, water problems, garbage problems, and etc.
One of the major problems is traffic problems. Within the last 2 decades, traffic problems in Bangalore has increased due to the development of automobile industries. Such a big mass production of automobile industries gives rise to public transport carrying more people compared to private car, they will occupy less space on the road.
Garbage is a major problem not only in Banda Bagicha area but in all over the city. When we surveyed the area, people complained that there were no bins provided by the municipal corporation. Not there was garbage collecting vans which would collect the garbage once a day. The major cause of this problem is people not being aware of the responsibilities towards the cleanliness of the society. The major effects are the garbage is accumulated on the sides of the road, which causes rush in the traffic. It also leads to increase in the number of stray dogs and breeding mosquitoes. These breeding mosquitoes cause hazardous diseases like dengue, malaria, and chikungunya.
Waterlogging problems were the major problems in the Banda Bagicha Road. When we talked to the people, they said that this problem was mainly faced in rainy season. The point was that the drains was not covered properly, and the garbage piles blocked the drains, and then the road was not constructed well, so the water gets collected on the roads. Due to this, the people face problems in traveling. The people who come from other areas to Yo China or 99 supermarket, they face problems in traveling. When we convey all these things to the municipal corporation, the in charge of garbage collection, Mr. Ravinder Singh, he said that they were working on it. By my opinion, the drain should be covered, proper drainage system should be there, and people should be aware of this. And if the government doesn't do this work, they have to complain for this because it's their responsibility and their duty to do so.
It is widely thought to be an effective way of increasing road safety at night. So the residents of Banda Bagicha Road demand that there should be effective street lighting to improve the road safety at night. So here are some of the measures which can be taken by the municipal corporation to solve the problems of street lighting. First, individual faults should be repaired within 5 days. Emergency situations should be dealt with within 1 day, and moreover, the areas which are prone to darkness during the night, they should be installed with the street lights. There are also some measures which can be taken by us to maintain the street lights. First, we should report to the municipal corporation if there is any damage to the street lights. Second, we should make the people aware of not seeing the bulbs or cause any other kind of damage to them.
Another problem is a safety problem. There is no safety at Banda Bagicha Road because the streets like located there are very dim. It is a one-way road, so no emergency exit, and traffic police is not there. So the solution for this problem is that the street lights should be changed, the traffic police should be pointed there, PCR one should be there, and public cameras should be pointed there.
The problem is road damage. It consists of all the obstructions and damages on the road. Nagarik or it is because of public interference or carelessness at the part of the government. Big holes on the road are the major cause of the accidents. No proper speed breakers, bumpers, jerks are the cause of uncomfortability. The major solution of these can be that the jerks and the bumpers could be smoothed so that there is smooth functioning in the movement of vehicles. And the big holes can be covered up so that the public does not face any problem.
The drainage system at the place was very poor. As we know, the drains should be covered, but what we saw that the drains were not covered. So we advised the people there to go and talk to the municipal corporation. But they replied that they have sent a lot of letters and talked to the municipal corporation. But
but the letters were denied and they were, the people were sent off and told that there is no solution for your problems. So we advise that you can find the solution of your problems by yourself. You can make the bricks by close by arranging these cemented bricks like structures and cover the drainage system.
Another major problem was the sanitation problem, because the drains were not covered, the garbage was spread here and there, and the pollution was there in the atmosphere. So many diseases spread like malaria, chikungunya, hepatitis A, typhoid, etc. So the solution for this problem is that the drains should be covered, garbage should be cleaned, and public toilets should be there.
When we asked the Municipal Foundation why they created it, they took criticism and decided to improve the social infrastructure like dispensary, police station, and maximum building that area. They also decided to launch a serious project like new sewer system, IC visit for sanitation practice, and improve the road like street lighting, increasing the net and the bread, and football, especially for the handicraft. They said that these steps will rapidly forward.
People at Banda Bagicha told us that if government takes a step forward, they would certainly support them.
Now, here is Ajay. The hook. Here the garbage, there the drain. From where you start cleaning, confusion in brain. No proper parking, roads unmetered. I think the problem is still not settled. Jerks in the car we face. There is no proper stamp to tie our shoelace. A dig here, a hole there. It's a public place. Crowd here, not here, then where? Everything is mismanaged. Not looked after. I don't think the matter is of a short laughter. No. Here the garbage, there the drain. Till where to end cleaning confusion in brain?
It is good to dream. My dream will open eyes come true very soon. Here is the part of a Banda Bagicha road which we have dreamt of. Here we are stating that what we saw in Banda Bagicha road was that the lanes, the footpaths were not available. So here we have explained that the footpaths here are available so that people don't find any difficulty to walk on the roads. And the roads were
showed on the map as well.
Yes,
as
well, ma'am. Just showed it on the board. And the roads were not wired. So we have shown them that the roads are wired. And the street lights were not working. So like we have shown like some streets, all the street lights here are working. The traffic lights were not available. As the, it is a very busy road, so traffic lights should be available. And the speed breaker should be also there. Zebra crossing is also there, so that people don't find any difficulty for crossing the roads. It is the Banda Bagicha road is also attached to Burdha Park. So Burdha Park actually was covered with the, all the garbage piles, so it should not be covered with garbage piles. So we have planned a good park so that the children can play or the people can walk over there. And the buildings were not, actually the buildings were very compact to each other. So here we have shown some of the buildings opposite to them. And parking not for in the ground, underground parking is also available. And the drainage system and the electricity supply should be in underground so that any shocks should be not available there. This is the old map, and here we have shown that the roads are not very much wider.
This is the new map of Banda Bagicha, and here we have shown the roads are wider, and there we can have a divider so that from one way the people can go, and from the one way the people can.
Here we have shown that the garbage are also available, but there is no garbage problem. The car parking is in the apartment itself. So the people who are coming from outside, they have to park in the apartment side. So that is not a good thing.
And here
Here we can see that we are having dustbins on place to place, and the street lights are appointed so that there is safety for the comers at night.
Look, at one of the most important things that lack among the people is awareness. If people will be aware, they will definitely develop the city along with the government. Hope people will be aware soon and be responsible citizens. Thank you.
You are in all present here. We are here to present our efforts, our civic project. Our efforts were in order to improve the condition of the road, Mauryapath. Now we'll further tell you about the road Mauryapath.
Mauryapath is a road situated in Khatla near Uttam Palace. It forms a T-intersection covered with drain of 5 meter width. It connects to Ashiana, which leads to Diga.
It divides into smaller roads, which make the way several columns. There are 5 apartments present on one side of the road and normal hotels present on both sides of the road. There are 2 automobile garages and 2 nursing homes present. Clubs occupy 30 meters of the road. The presence of shops and workshops are also present.
Problems on the road. There is a garden pile at the beginning of the road. Although the dustbin is provided, due to the high rate of diversion of garbage, the dustbin fills up very fast. There is uncovered drain on the side and there is no protection to it, so accidents can take place. The children of the slum play here and they are always under risk. The children of the slum also tame pigs, which are a major problem. The water logging takes place on the roads during the rainy season.
Garbage attracts street lights, street dogs which are not friendly to humans. The roads lack input paths and is quite narrow, which led to pass through vehicles at a time. The road is quite narrow and led 2 vehicles to pass at a time. The road is no footpath is present in the road to guide the people in the night as it take risk in the accidents or the related to drain.
On surveying the collected data, we found that there were some potholes in the way of pedestrians walking through it. Also, water gets accumulated on the surface of the road in the rainy season. Some people also said that there is heavy traffic in the area near Mauryapath during the afternoon and in the evening. Also, some said that there was high noise pollution in the area due to horns, which were not used carefully. We met some people who said that they themselves and their families have been suffering from several breathing problems, such as asthma and many. But we met very less, or say very rare people who had taken real initiatives to combat these problematic situations.
The road totally depends upon light coming from the nearby apartments, as there are no street light buildings. Gates are filled with garbage and are not clean regularly. All of them, we gave this road 3.18 points based on such criteria.
Solutions. A proper dumpyard should be made to clear the garbage that has accumulated on the road, and the drain should be covered and leveled with the road and made a part of the road. This will not only widen the road but also create space for buildings and footpaths. The slums should be shifted to a safer place and the street lights should be installed at a proper interval of 20 meters.
Actions taken to implement the solution. We thought that the person in this area best is Mr. Deepak Kumar Chaurasia, the World Counselor of World Number 2. We thought slums are not convenient in this area, so we decided with Mr. Deepak, and he said that some organizations are working on it. We also said that plantations should be planted which will grow in bigger trees in future.
We discussed with him the various issues of the present Mauryapath and also suggested him with the improvements of our proposal. We thought that this was not enough, so we hired a lift to clear the garbage at the beginning of the road. We also asked him to fill the potholes with bricks and sand.
long awaited work to cover the uncovered drains of Moripad has now started. The future of this road is positive and bright. As soon as the road will be covered, the road will become of 7 meters wide and it will have footpaths each of 1 meter wide, maybe more than 1 meter.
The Moripad Road forms a T intersection with the main goal, Bellevue. First of all, I want to say that this is not the whole model of the Moripad, since we could not make it. It is just a section of the Moripad and of Bellevue. It forms a T intersection. The length of the road is 230 meters now, and its width is 4 meters. The drain which is beside the road is 5 meters. So, in our proposed model, we want the road to be approximately 7 meter wide and the footpath should be 1 meter wide, which would make it easy for the travel of the vehicle. Also, we saw that there was lighting problem in the area. At night, there were accidents caused in this area. So, we want street lights to be implemented in this area at an alternate distance of 30 meters, so that it becomes easier for our citizens to travel. And we want greenery in this area, so we have planned of parks and the whole area to be green except for apartments. All basements should be removed and there should be grass on that for making it a better place.
This is the garbage pile at the beginning of the road, which we have shown in the these are the uncovered drains on which unwanted vegetation is growing. Various buildings are also present. We have a city hospital here. This is the approach on the road. They tame animals like pigs and birds like hens, which obstruct the road. Children from slums also play on the road, which is dangerous for them and us. So, in our proposed road, we have given slums a new place to live in. The road is widened. We have pedestrian crossings. We have planned for a footpath, which will be of about 1 meter wide. And street lights will be installed at alternately at every 20 meters, at a height of 5 meters. And we have planned to cover the drains, and there will be underground drainage, say 5 meters. We also have in this model, in this chart, we can see that there are marshy areas which fill with contaminated water and stagnant water on which unwanted vegetation is growing. In here, we also asked Mr. Deepak Sarasia to convert these marshy areas into parks and gardens on which children can play and people can walk.
If we succeed to plan, we plan to succeed.
Civic sense. Civic sense is nothing but social ethics. A lot of people think that civic sense is just keeping their roads, streets and cities clean. But it is much more than that. Civic sense has to do with law abiding, to respect all the fellow men, and to maintain the decorum of the public places.
Located in West Goring Canal Road, in ward number 23, and the third counselor is Prabhade. The width of the road is 10 meter and the length of the road is 60 meter. It has many major problems. So here I call upon my friends to tell you about the major problems.
One of the major problems in that area is encroachment of shopkeepers and vendors. The shopkeepers and vendors, they have encroached the road and there is space behind the road, there is space behind the shops. So we have decided to ask the shopkeeper to just strip back the shops so that roads could be widened. This is the solutions we have planned.
While surveying the road, we found that the garbage were dumped here and there. The garbage were open and smelly, and the people were not aware of that. The people did not raise their voice against it. The vendors covered half of the road and were mostly responsible for traffic jam. The solutions are: the garbage should be cleaned once in a while and should be covered, and the vendors should be given proper space for selling their materials.
We have found that there were only two street lights at the end of the street and that too were not in proper condition. Solution: proper street lights should be made so that during night time people feel secure.
The drains in that local road were in
dirty condition and the manholes were uncovered. Sometimes people threw garbage in there, which led to many diseases. And also during rainy season, water logging also occurred. So the solutions can be that the drains should be properly maintained and manholes should be properly covered.
In our CFS project, we have surveyed lot of people. We have asked them their name, age, occupation, problems and their views of improvement required in the road. The main problems they face are overcrowded road, busy traffic and the worst of their number of the ward.
We went to the PMC and interviewed the executive officer. He gave us a lot of information regarding the population of the urban Patna city, which is about 18 lakhs. They face a lot of problem in supplying water and electricity to each and every areas. Unauthorized buildings are being constructed in each part of the Patna city. The PPP is the main program which helps the ward to design and implement the plans which are made by them. Public-private partnership. It provides a huge amount of fund to each and every ward for its development. We had also interviewed the ward councillor who told us that the garbage were taken from this area and were dumped in the barrier village. The people there protested a lot. We also asked them what they were their future plans for the development of the roads. They told that the future plans were very much, but the less funds that were provided to them made them face a lot of problems.
Things we would like to share. Firstly, the scavengers and the sweepers are still treated as untouchables. This should be banned as they are the ones who clean us in. Secondly, we have requested the PMC to install solar lights instead of the CFL lights as they are cost effective.
The main motto of the PMC should be installing the 3 R's: recycle, reuse and recharge.
This is the closest track of Panipuri, which is situated less boring than our road. The road is in pathetic condition and the slope itself has been closed on the road. The length of the road is 60 meters and the breadth of the road is 10 meters. The drain is full covered with garbage and due to encroachment of roads, there are heavy traffic.
There should be street lights along the road and a park for evening walk and rest. The drain should be covered and the garbage cart should come at least once in 2 days to collect the garbage.
Here we have a poem for Civic Pen. This project is for Civic Pen and we are glad it never gave us a moment of rest. Survey is what we started with and it sure bring all the men. For the condition of roads in Anandpuri is in a pathetic state of worry. Thank you.
While doing this survey work, we gather a lot of information and have collected records in different parameters involved in this data. As per the map is represented, such as the famous part of station road has 1.28 and is a type of archaic road. According to the data collected, we saw that nothing is in a very good condition. The water quality is bad. The drains and sanitation on that area is poor. There is increase in pollution level. There is no street light which is in a very good condition. The collection of people. We surveyed the people living there and came to know that they had negative views for the development of that road. We surveyed 20 people living there and the only answer to our questions was that they were not satisfied by the drainage system, water quality and many more problems that you are facing in their day-to-day life.
There were many problems related to the road. So, we divided them in 6 main topics, which were water quality, drainage and hydration, garbage and pollution, street lights, parks and restrooms, and walkability and manpower. The water quality was really very poor. The water which was supplied was not up to the mark. Even the drain was not in a proper condition. garbage and pollution, street light and walkability and footpath. Instead of being garbage inside the dustbin, they were thrown near the dustbin, and it was done mostly by those people who travel to that area. While interacting with the people, we get to know that there were many people who were asthma patients, and it was only because of air pollution. Going to that road at night was really very dangerous because none of the street light was given there.
The footpaths were there, but of no use, as the poor people living there occupied it for their own living. And also, the footpaths were full of garbage. There were no restrooms, and only one park, the Weed Prevention Park, which used to be closed all the time.
The road to construction is always The road to success is always under construction, but you can still try your best to make the road look better and even perfect. So here are some solutions to our problems. Since our road was located near the railway station, so it was a very busy road, and a busy road means a lot of pollution. This can only be regulated by planting more and more trees and increasing the green cover of the area. Then the garbage problem. All the garbage of the area was collected on the opposite side of the road. So this can be shifted on the outskirts of the city, and the vacant area can be converted into a chore for the encroachments, so that the footpath also becomes obstruction free. Also, drains should be covered and cleaned timely, and proper sanitation should be encouraged among the people.
Quality of water given to the vendors were completely different. First of all, this should be changed. They should be provided clean drinking water. Proper ventilation should be done for further improvement. The place where we visit was having one park, which was not at all well maintained. So we need to maintain it. And the place where we visit the vacant area to parking areas, parks and restrooms.
Now I am here to show the changes between the existing and the redesigned map. First, in the existing map, as you can see, there are a lot of garbage and encroachments have been put by, and it is full of obstructions. Whereas in the redesigned map, we have removed all the obstructions, tried to clean all the garbage and converted this vacant area into a chore. Also, here there was a garbage area which is converted into a restroom, park and a parking area.
A lot in that road, we came to a conclusion that we must have created awareness among the people. When we, school children, step out of our homes and survey about the life of the people and the road they live in, they even get encouraged and help us in our work. This makes us promising that whenever we grow up and take up administration, we will surely improve and develop their livelihood. We have been to encourage people. We have even made some slogans and singles. And they are, the road to success is always under construction.
Keep the road clean and don't make the dustbin.
Make the changes in your life so that you won't suffer.
If you will care for the road, then the road will care for you.
Do something to keep the road clean.
If the roads are not well designed, then we will not be the destination. Thank you and hope you like our presentation.
Scene 1. Our city office and how there are people set up, people sitting around.
Gentlemen, we are here today to discuss about a dream city. Actually, we are here to plan about how we can make a city better.
What do you want to achieve actually from this meeting? For making a city better, we need an ideal road. An ideal road is something which is smooth, congestion-free, with free-flowing traffic, neat and clean, with green cover.
Can we do this for our city, Patna? Maybe.
Our city office, a group of social workers, bark inside the room.
Good morning. What's happening? Why are you here early morning?
We need a notable council for the discussion. We have intense problems in the Meena Pushkar Road and need your help. Please visit with us.
Let's visit and have an inspection. It's so important.
Okay, go. But I will go. I will rest. Bring me a cup of tea.
Shigri, meet up with Sachin Mandeo. Some street vendors gather around the office here.
Where they are not allowed at all to
move or cross the street, the line which is made for them. If they do so, then their cards are seized and it goes to the municipal department. So this area would be for the street vendors, and these shops will be made by the governments in order to make for the people who have encroached on the land, on the road itself. Now, as you know, in the map, we have shown this proposal to again HOD of our city. He said that this plan is extremely good. He said that we will have this plan because we, as you can see here on the pavements, we have street lights which would help the people moving towards downwards. Secondly, under the pavement, we can have drainage system which would help, which would not stink at all, and it would be passed through the pipes downwards also. Then we can have under parking on the bridges. As you can see, we can have parkings here. Moreover, the bridge is 25 meter broad, and people can move easier, and we can have shops here, and houses can be built. Here we can, you can see dustbins. Here the peels of the vegetables and all can be taken here, and it can be converted into biogas, which would be naturally helpful for the people. And the street vendors also would be shifted towards the extreme position of this road, and it would help the people to move easier. We have street lights here, as you can see, and these are planned by the PMC department. They have also said that we are going, if the road is constructed by the end of March, he will construct the road to of the Mithapur.
Do you have it in writing?
Writing that the paper, he has given a letter, but.